Hello and welcome.
We're here today. I want to talk about a pretty interesting circuit combination that we see, well, that we actually don't really see that often. So what I want to talk about is called a three-phase, four-wire, delta circuit, right? So usually the most common voltage we'll see with this would be a 120/240 volts, right? Three-phase, four-wire delta. So now these are very uncommon, but we kind of saw them a while ago. There's still a couple of code rules to do with them, so you may see them around, and it's a pretty interesting circuit. So what we have, right, we have 120/240 three-phase, so we can run three-phase loads, but we also have the ability to run some 120 volt loads like receptacles or lights or things like that. So the way it works is these are a connection made on the secondary of a transformer to give us this option. And the way that connection works or looks is we'll have our three windings. Connected up in delta, just like they always are, right? We would have phase C, phase B, or line feed B, line C, line A. Then what happens is they will take the B phase, so from B to C, and they will center tap it. So they will tie into the middle, and they will get a neutral conductor from there. Now, what we see there, right, because our voltage was from A to B, 240, from B to C, 240, and from C to A, 240, right, our three-phase delta voltages, when we center tap that winding, we're taking a 240 volt winding and we're cutting it in half, meaning from B to N, I get 240 volts. And from C to N, or sorry, 120. From B to N, I get 120 volts. And from C to N, I get 120 volts. So what we start to see is something that actually looks kind of like this. So I'm gonna do a little phasor diagram over here. Not a great one. But we have our standard three-phase delta voltages, right? We have V A to B, V B to C, and V C to A, right? And we know, if you've watched my other videos or you know about delta, V A to B is at zero, B to C is at 240, and C to A is at 120. Now, what we're going to talk about is these voltages here, right? So here, I would read VB to N, right? And B to N, we said, is 120 volts. And it's the same polarity as VB to C, only it's half. So we actually see VB to N right there. So in this case, VB to N would equal 120 volts. At 240 degrees. Okay, now the other one here, we would call this V C to N is what we would call it. And if we were plotting that onto a phasor diagram, it would actually be, it's on the B phase, right? But we're gonna measure from C to N, so the opposite direction of B to C, which actually puts it up here, V C to N. In this case, that would be C to N, it would be 120 volts at 60 degrees, right? So any loads you put on that would be based off of that 60 degree voltage. Awesome. Now that's very cool. So what we have now is we have the ability to run three phase loads, as well as we have these two 120 volt phases, which we can run 120 volt loads, right? So different receptacles, lighting, thing like that. Now what we end up with is something very special here. If we were to take a meter, and this is something we cannot do, but the measurement is important and why the code rules come into play are important. What if we were to take a meter and measure V A to N? So measure from A to my neutral. Well, let's talk about that for a sec. So V A to N would be A to B, right? Plus B to N. So V A to N would equal V A to B plus V B to N. Right, again, we're going A to B plus B to N, and we're measuring those two points. Now we would add those up vectorally, right? Meaning we would probably use an HV chart. So A to B was 240 volts at 0 degrees, plus B to N, which is 120 volts at 60 degrees. So we would end up getting an HV chart that would look something like this. So we add up those and we end up seeing that our VA to N equals 208 volts at 330 degrees. Now what's important about that is the voltage itself. This V to A to N value right here. That is called our high leg voltage. Our high leg voltage, you cannot use it. So now there's some rules in the code book, which I'll post the rules below in the description so you can reference them yourself. What it tells us is it tells us that phase A is to be the phase with the high voltage to ground, meaning I have to center tap phase B down here, right? I can't center tap C because then A would not be the high voltage to ground. So phase A has to be that high leg, or line A has to be that high leg. It also tells us that the system shall be constructed so that you can never, ever, ever connect A to N for a load. All right, so what ends up happening is this. So because we cannot connect anything from A to N, you end up with a system that usually works out something like this. So we will have our center tapped three phase, right? A, B, C, and neutral, right? This is A, B, neutral, and C, just like we have over here. It'll go into some type of splitter. B, neutral, C. Then you'll have two panel boards. This one will be a three phase, three wire, right? And it will see A, B, and C, right? So it's a three phase, three wire panel. It's got line A, line B, and line C. The other one will be a completely separate situation. It will be a single phase, three wire, right? 120, 240. And it will see B, neutral, and C. It will not have access to A and neutral in the same panel board. So here is A, B, C, and here down here would be A, or sorry, B, neutral, and C, right? So they cannot be in the same equipment. So I hope that makes a little bit of sense right there, what I'm showing. So it's a pretty interesting situation. Like I said, in theory, it's a very cool concept to have the option of three phase loads at 240 volts and single phase 120. While still only supplying, right? This could be really, really long transmission lines. I only need those three conductors. I don't need a Y system, right? So pretty cool application of a delta system. So thanks a lot for watching. Make sure you check out my other videos below on the delta systems, and have a great day.